channel. Thank you for clicking on this video. So today I want to just show how to balance your child's pattern. Okay, so actually this video is meant for my students in the paid class, in the child's paid class. So but I just decided to bring it here on YouTube. Okay, so I have taught them in the paid class how to draft basic pattern, like basic child's pattern and some other things. So we want to balance our pattern, we want to balance our child's pattern. So but because of those of you that are not yet in the class, I will be drafting the basic for this pattern. Okay, so if you want to be part of that class, it's just for a token, okay? But you will still learn a lot from this video, so keep watching. And if you like to subscribe to this channel, please click on that subscribe button, turn on the notification bell so you will not miss out on any of our upcoming videos, and we have a lot coming up on this channel, okay? So there are points we need to note when we are drafting our pattern. So let me show you the projects from my students. Okay, they are actually doing well. From the lesson we had, they have been able to make trousers even for the first time, and we're able to come up with trousers as you can see on the screen. Okay, these are my students' projects, and you can see how wonderfully well they are doing. So I just want to explain certain things to them. Okay, most especially when it comes to the crotch, to avoid, you know, having trousers like this, as you can see on the screen, trousers with so much draping at the back, or you know, the crotch either encroaching, there's the crotch depth encroaching into your crotch, and then some other things you see, the trousers not balancing well on your body. There are things you can do to avoid that, even if you don't have 100%. Nice looking trousers, at least you get about 99%. Okay, following this idea I'll be giving you here. So the points to note are your crotch depth. You need to know how to place your crotch depth very well. You don't over curve and don't, you know, shallow curve. Okay, let me use that way. And the allowances you place in also matter. The way you take your measurement matters as well. In the paid class, I showed how to take measurement for trousers, so you can join. It's actually for a token, it's not much, you don't pay so much. And slanting of your waistline, these are things you need to take note of. So I will go straight into drafting my trouser basic pattern. Like I said, I'll be talking, you know, as if I'm talking to my students. So if you're not yet in the class, please bear with us. Okay, so I'm actually doing this for my student by side to bring it here. Now, before you start drafting your trouser pattern, there are different ways to draft your trouser pattern. I have tried, you know, a lot of ways, and the very one I taught in that class is one, it's among the easiest, the straightforward, and the one that would, you know, go with all body type. You know, we have different body type and sizes. There are trouser methods you will use that will not go well with people with big tummy. There are trouser patterns you will use that will not go well with people with big butts. Okay, that this very method goes for everybody. That is why I chose to teach this very method. So there are methods that when you use them, because of the slanting, the crotch becomes smaller. If you don't know what to do, you have a very small crotch, and that will be a problem. And there are methods that when you use them at the back of your trouser, it will look as if the person is sagging because you didn't create enough room for the butt, right? Okay, but this very method, like I say, will work. Now, for this method, I'll be teaching you, whether you're drafting on your fabric or on paper, you have to, you know, create allowance at this part, at this side of your fabric or your trouser. Okay, so I also taught how to draft, how to cut directly on fabric. There are methods of cutting trouser that you must use paper because you have to slash the front, raise it to be able to get the back. But in this one, you can draft directly on your fabric. Okay, so what do you do at this side of your paper or your fabric? If you're cutting directly on your fabric, you have to fold your fabric. Okay, so I think I should just use two paper so that it will look as if I folded. Like I just show you the complete outlook at the end. Okay, So I have, you know, taken on that paper so I can look as if I have placed my fabric or my paper on fold. So I want you to see the outcome, how it will be by the time I am done drafting, okay? So this will help me also show you how to join a crotch and every other thing. So now, by the time you have folded your fabric, what you will do, at this side, mark at least, I use the word at least, it shouldn't be low, it shouldn't be less than one, okay? But it can be more than one, you can use 1.5. So at least 1 inch is what you should mark here, depending on the allowance you want to add to your trouser. For me, I prefer adding 1/2 inch because it is trouser, we don't need so much allowance inside. So I prefer adding 1/2 inch. So in that case, I will mark 1 inch on this side of my fabric. So from top to bottom, just mark 1 inch and draw your line. So I have drawn my line, as you can see. After doing this, at the top, you still need to draw your line as well, 1 inch, okay? At least 1 inch. So we are cutting the front. After cutting the front, we cut the back. So my students in the paint class are already used to this, okay? So please, if you want to get the full details of our trouser making, you can just WhatsApp the number you can see on the screen. Send WhatsApp message so that you can get details of the training, okay? So by the time you have done this now, it is time to start drafting your trouser. So you're going to place your vertical measurements. So the vertical measurements are the measurements, you know, along the body. Now, we'll call this line now the waistline, okay? So from the waistline, you place your hip points. So I have, you know, given the video in the... So we have the video on how to take the measurements in our paid class. So you place your hip points. Your crotch depth, okay? So the hip point here is 9 inches, the crotch depth is 9.5. Then you place the new point, okay? The new point here is 22. And you place the full length of the trouser, which is also the ankle point, or wherever you want your trouser to get to, okay? So in this case, it is 35. So we'll add 2 inches for hemming, okay? So that is it. So now I'll just repeat these points at the midpoint of my paper so that I can draw my line, okay? Just want to draw line. Now, another thing is this. In case you're drafting directly on your fabric, you might want to know the length of fabric you should fold, because you're not going to just fold your total fabric or all the big fabric you're using. You need to fold it depending on the measurement or size of trouser you're making. So to fold your fabric, what you need is your round tie measurement, okay? Your round tie measurement divided by 2. So by the time you measure your round tie divided by 2, whatever you get, add at least 3 inches. That is 1 inch on this side and 2 inches that you need on this side just for cutting out. It's not compulsory, but you just need it. You can even use 1 inch. But to be on the safe side, I always give this advice. It's better to have excess than having shortage. So what you will do, in this case, the round side is 24. Divide by 2 is 12, right? Plus 3. So I've added 1 here already. What I need is 2 on this side. So this is it. So this is actually where, okay, I'll have my trousers. My trousers will fall in within this part. So this is to help you manage your fabric, so I don't end up folding everything and just cutting anyhow. So this is where I would, you know, this is, my trouser will fall within this area, okay? So now, like I said, I will repeat the point I've made here. My hip measurements, my crotch depths. I also gave a formula on how to get your crotch depth. Or even when you can measure that on your body, it's in the course, it's in the fifth class. The full length and the ankle. That is, the ankle is the full length. Then 2 inches for hemming. Okay, that is 2 inches hemming allowance. So what I'll do now is just to draw the lines. So, having drawn my lines, now I'll label. This is the hip point, this is the crotch, this is the knee, and this is the ankle, then this is the allowance, okay? Some people place their thigh measurement to when drafting trousers, but that is optional. Why I say it is optional is this. At this crotch line, the measurement to be placing there is equivalent to the round thigh measurement. So it is optional. But if in case you want to just place the round thigh, what you will do, measure 3 inches from your crotch line. 3 inches from your crotch line will give you, okay, that is where you have the thigh measurement, okay? Like I said, it is optional. Now, having done this, we will now place our hip circumference. So the hip measurement divided by 4 is what you place here. So in this case, it is 9.5. Okay. Me, I am not adding any ease. Like when you're making trouser for little boys, for young boys, you might want to add ease to be free, both on the waistline and at the hip, okay, so they can, you know, as they're growing, trouser will still fit them and they can wear it with belt. But for adults, mostly female, we usually like our trousers to be fitted at the hip. So bear in mind that whatever ease you are adding at your hip point would affect your crotch. Okay, to affect your crotch. So that is why this tutorial is about balancing our trousers. So whatever ease you'll be adding at this hip point, there are 2 ways to place your crotch. Either you measure what you have here, that is from this hip point to this hip point, divide by 4. That is what you mark after your crotch extension. Those in the class already know. But if you're not using that way, because some people, what they do here is they place their thigh, round thigh measurement here. So if you're placing your round thigh measurement here, bear in mind that whatever ease you are adding at the hip will affect your crotch. So it's better to just follow the method I'm doing here, okay? So by the time you have mark your hip circumference divided by 4 here, you also mark it at the crotch line and at the waist. So what I had here was 9.5. I would also mark it at this crotch. Okay, let's be sure. Yeah, okay, this is it here. And at this crotch depth, you mark it as well. And you also mark it at the waist line. Mark it at the waistline. So by the time you have marked your hip circumference at the waistline, at the hip line, and at the crotch line, what you will do is connect. Just connect the points. Okay? Now you can see the line we have here. It is time to place our crotch extension. This is where you have to be careful, because to avoid all these drapings we see on trousers, sometimes this is where the problem lies. Okay, this is where the problem lies. So my students, pay attention. A lot of you got it right, while some of us are still, you know, some of you are still trying to get it right. Now, to get this crotch extension, like I was saying before, what some people do is that they measure their round thigh. Like for example, the round thigh here is 24. They measure the round thigh divided by 2. So round thigh divided by 2 is 12. This is where it will be, 12 inches. So just mark it, okay? Then another method to use is to measure what you have here on this hip line, from here to here. Whatever you have, divide it by 4, and that is what you place here. So why it is good to use this method is in case you have added ease to your hip measurements. In case you have added ease. So whatever you have added, by the time you divide it by 4, that is what you place here. Okay? So that's why it's good to use this other method. So I would measure what I have here and divide it by 4. Okay? So to divide by 4 is simply folding your tape into 4. Whatever you have, you place it there. So it is, you can see it is actually accurate. It's the same thing. It's still at that point. But if I had added ease to my hip circumference, what I would mark here would have been different. I hope you can see. Let's say if I have added half inch ease, okay, and then I got it here. I don't want to mark it. Let me use my chalk. If I added half inch ease, you know, by the time I measure from here to this point and divide it by 4, what I will get would extend, okay, will be more than what I have here. So I hope this is clear to you now. So we need to know the method we are using and the principles that goes with those methods. Okay, so by the time you have done this, another thing you need to take note of is the curve you'll be placing here. The curve matters a lot. If you curve too deep, it will affect your crotch in such a way that you have some fold and you have the crotch line going, okay, encroaching into your crotch. Then if you cut it too outward, you have a lot of fabric pumping out there. So the best way to do it is this. From this point, okay, from this point where we mark the hip line, just come out by 1 inch, okay? Just come out by 1 inch. By the time you come out by 1 inch, try to connect from this point to this point and just to this line. Don't curve it up, because I've seen some people just curve it up without actually taking note of what they're doing. Or without actually, you just curve it and at the end you have something like C here. No. You would make sure you connect from this point to that 1 inch step out, and from that 1 inch step out back to this hip line. Okay? Like so. And to help you, you can use your French curve. Okay? So I'll be leaving a link in this in the description box where you can get your pattern making tools. Okay, mostly if you're in Nigeria and some part of Africa, you can order for your pattern drafting tools. Okay, so you have French curve, you have a pattern master, your trouser curve. Okay, they're there. So, like I was saying, you just connect. So you can use your French curve, connect from this point. Hope you can see this. Hope my hand is not blocking. Connect to this point and to the hip line. So just want to make sure it goes smoothly, okay? And you just blend it a little bit here. Don't want it sharp. So I think I have made a mistake there. So, but this is just how it should go. You connect from here to that 1 inch to this hip line. And you can see what we have. It is not too, I didn't go beyond this hip line and I didn't come out too much, so it's just like that. Okay, so this is just a guide how you should curve your crotch. Okay, this is how you should curve your crotch. Now this is for the front. By the time you have curved your crotch, the next thing, you take your hip, your waist circumference, you place your waist circumference. So here the waist circumference divided by 4 is 8.5. I would mark 8.5 from this side. I'll mark 8.5. Now you can add that, but that in front of the trouser is optional. In fact, in modern trousers, we don't see that in front anymore. Okay, that seems to be outdated. That in front. But if you still want to have that in front of the trouser, what you will do is this. That if you still want to have that at the front pattern of the trouser, by the time you have placed your waist circumference, add allowance for the dart. So if you're using 1 inch dart, make sure you add 1 inch allowance for your dart. Okay? So, but I'm not using that. So by the time you have marked your waist circumference, carefully connect it to the crotch line. This is another place where some people make mistakes. Okay? Some people will just curve it in a way that, you know, I think they want to just add a fisher hip. We'll just curve it from this point to this point. It is strong. If you do that, you'll be having excess fabric at the hip area by the time you're done joining your trouser. So just connect it naturally. So I usually use my trouser, my pant curve, that is trouser curve, to just connect it slightly from that point. But you can still do this with your ruler to avoid any unnecessary curve there. Just from your waist to the crotch line, just connect like so. You will see the hip curve forming naturally on its own when you get to that level. Okay, So, because this is not where the hip will form, the hip will actually form at this hip area. Okay? So, now, having done this, you're going to measure what you have. You know, this, you see this crotch line. Okay, measure what you have from this point to this point. Okay, so actually, usually we do that before placing the hip measurement, but all the same, it's still the same thing. By the time you measure it, I have 12 inches. So you find midpoint of it, that is half of it. So since it's 12, half of it is at 6 inches. Okay, so that is it. So you make sure it's at 6 inches. You measure from here, 6 inches. Now, this 6 inches, just mark it. From the top to the lower part, just mark 6 inches. Okay, so note I am measuring from this line I made. So, and so come here, you mark the 6 inches at the ankle and at the allowance. You also mark the 6 inches. So we are creating the green line. Okay, so by the time you're done marking, just connect. So this is called the gray line. This is where you have that, you know, where what we call keto line, when you iron your trouser. That line you usually see at that front. By the time you fold the trouser to iron, this is that point. So, and it helps to, you know, give our trouser shape. For us to shape our trouser, or for us to balance our trouser, this is where this is the line we make use of. So it is necessary you create this line. So by the time you have done this, now we have placed the waist circumference, right? So we come to the new circumference. Here we have our hip circumference already. We have gotten our crotch measurement already. So what we have here now is to place the new circumference divided by 2. Okay, so normally it's divided by 2. But to make it easy for you, just divide your knee circumference by 4. Whatever answer you get, place it on this side and place it on this side as well. Following this green line, you place on this side, and from this green line, you also place on this side. So in this case, the knee circumference is 18, divided by 4, that is 4.5. So I will mark 4.5 on this side, and I will mark 4.5 on this other side, like so. Okay, then by the time you come to the ankle, your round ankle divided by 4 as well, you place it. So in this case, the round ankle divided by 4 is 3.75. so this is 3.75. I'll mark it, and on this side, 3.75. okay, and there it is. Now this is where this brings us to balancing our trouser. Like I said initially, this measurement you have placed, when you are taking measurement of the body, please balance it in such a way that if you're making a fitted trouser, I'm talking to my students now, okay, please, if you're making a fitted trouser, make sure that the measurement you are placing balance. You don't over make this side so bold, like when you're measuring on the body, this side will not be so bold, and at the end you come and make this side pencil. Let it balance. If you're making a fitted trouser, make sure you measure your round knee the way you want it. Okay, so whatever ease you are adding to that round knee, make sure it matches up with what you are having at the ankle, so that you don't have trouser that you have so much fabric at this side and this side will be so pencil. So make sure everything aligns, okay, the way it should. Now, having marked all this point, we would connect. Then another issue we usually have is this pant curve. If you don't know how to place it, you might end up overcutting this part of the trouser, the thigh area. So this curvy side is actually meant for the back. Okay, so I'm teaching you this now for those of you that don't know how to use it. This curvy area is usually meant for the back. It is the back that should be, you know, curved deeper. But for the front, it is also necessary that it curve a little, but not too deep. So you can just like move from the top of your pant curve, you move down a little bit, and you connect from this crotch measurement to your knee, like so. Okay, you might say, what if you don't have the fan cord? You can do this with your ruler. But after connecting it straight, please curve it a little bit if it's necessary. Now, let's just connect straight with my chalk. Okay, it shouldn't be this straight. So you have to, let's say, you know, just step in a little bit and just curve it. So that's why this the curve ruler is very necessary when you're making your trousers, okay? Because if you see our trousers, the shape is not just, unless you want to just have it straight like that, okay? But this curve gives it some kind of fitting and helps it to balance at the crotch area without having so much fabric and draping and that part. That is why this curve was created, to take away those draping and excess fabric you see. Okay, so you need to try to use this, but if you're not using it, just try to curve your hand a little bit. So what you need to do, just connect. Let me use my marker so that you can see it. Okay, so you can see it's not so straight and not too curvy, but at the back we'll have to place it so that it curves a little bit, because we're having allowance at the back. So now, having done this, at this other side too, you connect. So this is how I place my pant curve, to connect from the crotch to the knee. Okay, so you just place it this way and you connect. So by the time you connect, you now see that your hip shape has formed naturally without it over exaggerating it. Because if you overcreate it here, by the time you join, you have so much fabric on this side. So now you can see the top part of our trouser. The next thing is to connect from the knee to the ankle. So just connect from the knee to the ankle. Make sure you place your ruler well and you connect, okay? Then you come to this side, you connect as well. So when you have done this, now for the allowance, you don't just go straight. You don't go straight. I'm using chalk so I don't have double lines there. So you don't just go straight like this. If you go straight, by the time you try to fold, you see that this one would go in. It will not match up with this side. So what I usually do, either you fold your fabric inward like this when you want to cut. You fold it inward like this before you cut, okay? Or you extend it. Now that I have marked this, I have made this mark here. From the mark, you can come out by half inch or quarter of an inch, just a little bit. Okay, making sure that it is a little bit extended from this initial line. Okay, so let me use quarter of an inch. Like I said, you can use half inch, you can use quarter of an inch, but make sure that whatever you're using on this side is the same thing you're using on this other side, so that your trouser would balance when you are stitching it. Okay, so that is it. Now, let me extend it with my marker, so I still have the. So this I should go, and like this. Okay, so you can see the shape we have here. This is my trouser pattern. Now, by the time you have gotten this, the next thing to do is to place your allowance all round. Okay, it is necessary. Some people don't do that, but for this very method I'm teaching you, it is necessary. That is why I said you should create this space here and the space at the top. Okay, so like I said, half inch is what I use. Now, what you do at this point, you mark half inch from the waistline. At every point, you just mark half inch. And what you do later on is to connect. You can see from the nail, yeah, I'm marking the half inch. Ankle the same thing, and at the lower part the same thing. Okay, so you mark half inch and you connect. You do the same thing on this side, you mark half inch and connect, and at the top you do the same thing, you mark half inch and you connect everything, okay? So, you can see this, I've added half inch all round, apart from here, because this is the hem allowance, okay? Now, we are good to cut, but this is just a trouser pattern. In case you want to add zipper fly to it, you know, that you will cut separately. But we have another method of making a zipper fly, whereby we cut it together. Then, if you're not making zipper fly and you want to add zipper to this, what you will do is you add a zipper allowance here, okay? So since you have half inch here, just add another half inch. That is, your zipper allowance should be 1 inch, okay? So you just add it from this point to, that is, from this top to your hip line, just add 1 inch zipper allowance, and that is it. Then this one is actually a trouser that would not have band. If your trouser will be having band, then in mind that you have to minus the length of the band. So that was taught, or I taught that in the paid class, okay? So now I'll go ahead and cut, okay? Since it's just illustration, I'm not adding zipper, I'm just showing you how to do this. Those in paid class already know how to print the zipper fly, fix zipper and everything. This is just about, this very tutorial is about balancing your trouser. And then, you know, I'm still talking more about the crotch area, okay, to avoid all those drifting. So now I'll go ahead and cut. One more thing, if you want to add pockets, that is already taught in our trouser class, please. So here is my trouser pattern. So while I was cutting, the other paper was actually shifting, so I had to use pin. So I don't usually cut two papers, I use only one because it is paper. But I just want to show you up the, you know, final, the outlook at the end. So that is why I used two paper, and then one was actually moving away from the original, from the other one. That's why I have this discrepancy here. So I have to trim it well so that it would be equal. Okay? Right, so equal. So I want you to see how to balance your trouser. So this is okay. Okay, so we use this one to cut the back. Just making some adjustments, so I've not cut this top. Okay. So here it is. Now we'll use this to cut the back. Okay. So the back will not be exactly the way the front is. We'll have some things to do there, of the butt rise. So now let me place my paper and cut the back. I've also placed my back and fabric on fold. So let's just assume you're using fabric. You still need to place your back fabric on fold. So when placing your front, there are things you need to bear in mind. Your back pattern should be longer than the front because of the butt rise. So if your pattern is not enough, you should add more, that is, you can join it. Okay, so my pattern will not be enough. Let me see. Because what you should have above here should be up to what you have here. That is the measurement from this point to this point, 3 inches. So let's see if I have 3 inches there. I don't have 3 inches. For the sake of this, just because this is a, because this is just a tutorial, I'm not going to use this pattern. I'm not using it to cut any trouser. So I want to reduce this allowance. So let me just reduce this allowance here. So this other paper will be enough for my back. So the top part is the most important part. So I want to show you. So let me just cut out this side. So if you want to get a full video on how to make your trousers, register for our trouser class, okay? And you also have the opportunity to ask questions. And just reduce this allowance so that this other pattern can be enough for me without me wasting. Now I've doubled it already. If I have to cut another paper and join, I'll be wasting my paper. I'm not using this pattern on any trouser unless I just want to make a short trouser. This is actually a real measurement, okay? Not the length that is the problem. So at this top, the space you should have at this top should be up to what you have from this point to this point, okay? That's the space you should have here. Then the space you should have here should be up to half of what you have from this point to this point. So let me just extend this line, okay? Should be up to what you have here. So normally I usually say take up to 3 to 4. So let me just measure, okay? So let me use 3.5, so this side is okay. So when you have done this, you can pin your paper down or you use tape to hold it down. So it doesn't move when you are drafting the back. You don't want it moving because you're going to use part of the front to get our back. So you don't want it shifting. So I usually use tape and paper tape to just hold it down. So now when you have done this, measure this line. Okay, one more thing, we will not add another allowance at the back because we are taking both, that we have added allowance at the front, so we are taking it or transferring it to the back the way it is, okay? So after drafting, we're not adding another allowance at the back. So what I have is 2, that is 4, is this measurement. The half, that is the midpoint of it, is at 2, this is it. So from this midpoint now, just mark it, just note it, okay? Then you measure what you have here. You see this crotch line, like this crotch extension. Measure it. You are taking the allowance, everything. So I have 3 inches. So what I will do now is come here and mark 3 inches from this initial line because I've taken the allowance at this side. Okay, so from this initial waistline, you place your 3 inches and you mark at the top here. Okay, so I hope you are seeing what I'm doing here. Let me shift it. I said you measure. Yeah, just in case you didn't see it, I'm not looking at my camera. So what you have at this crotch line, this crotch extension, measure it and place it from this waistline. Okay, place it from this initial waistline because I've taken allowance from here and you mark it. So just mark it. So you can actually draw the line to guide you, but for me not to have double line, I'll just mark it. So this is the point you actually need, this one. Now you go to this crotch line. Come out by 2 inches. We are taking the allowance, so you mark from the allowance here. Come out by 2 inches. Okay, you just note it. Then from that point where you mark 2 inches, you would come down by 1/2 inch. So the essence of this is just because of the butt and the back. You know, the front and the back are not the same. The back is fuller, so just come down by 1/2 inch so that the crotch length, crotch depth on the back will be longer. So when you have come out by 1/2 inch, this is the line here, this is the mark here. From this crotch point here, come out by 2 inches. Okay, wherever the 2 inches, wherever you find it, just mark it. Mark it. Okay, even if it's under this thing, you find it, mark it there. Now, this is time to be careful. I've seen crotch depth that are forming sort of C shape. It is wrong. That is why when you sow the chaff, either it is pushing into the pot, or if you overextend it, you have a lot of fabric at that pot area. Okay, so these are the points I have made. This point, and this point, we are connecting it. Now, just take this one straight. That is, don't curve it. This particular point from here to here, don't curve it. Just connect it slant the way it is. Just connect it naturally. Okay, let me use that word. So don't add your own curve. Just connect it like this, first of all. Okay, so I believe this is where some of us usually miss it. We tend to curve this side and it's not okay. So by the time you have connected from this side to this side, now you would now connect from this side to this side using your curve. Just slightly, slightly. You can see how I connected it. So your French curve will always help you. You can see what I have there. Okay, so when it looks sharp here, all you need to do is just blend it. So you can see what it looks like. It is not too deep, it is not forming C shape. Some people's crotch does form C shape. That will not give you a balanced trouser. So this is our crotch for the back, okay? Our crotch curve for the back. And you see the crotch curve for the front. Now, by the time you have done that, you come to this top now. What you will do is place your waist measurement. So to get it right, always extend this waist line. Okay, so I know where you have it. Okay, so you would place your waist measurement. So the waist circumference here is 8.5, okay? So what you would do is, you would measure where you have 8.5 from this point to this point. Then, if you'll be adding that at the back, make sure you add your that allowance. So let's say we'll be adding that at the back, 1 inch that, right? So since the waist measurement is 8.5 plus 1 inch that, that will be 9.5. So from here, just place your tape from this point to meet this line where you have your measurement. So I have 9.5. So you can see it here. I'll mark it. Okay? So by the time I mark it, what I'll do is just to connect like so. Okay, so for those in my faith class, I'm just repeating this again in case you know you just want to like refresh again. This is it, okay? Now, when you have done this, you come to this crotch line, come out by 1 inch. Okay, come out by 1 inch. It is standard. Ordinarily, at this crotch point, what we are supposed to add, the crotch, what you are supposed to add to back crotch, you know, is 3 inches generally. But since we are using 2 on this side, the remaining 1 should be placed on this side to balance your trouser. Okay, so now you would connect from this point to this point. Just connect naturally. Okay, so I'm just using the word naturally, so I won't curve it by yourself. Not add artificial hip or artificial curve. Just connect, okay? So, having done this, it is now time to connect the other parts. Okay, connect this very one is going to be fitted. Okay, for straight cut, we have that in our paint class, we have palazzo, we have bell bottom. Okay, but this one is just fitted. So what I will do is to connect from this point. So another thing you need to do, at this nail, you add 1/2 inch. Okay? So the essence of doing this is that the back part of our body is fuller. So we won't always create that roll. Okay, so if you only see your trouser, you see that the back side is bigger than the front side. So, but I don't add too much so that it will balance well. Okay, so 1/2 inch here and 1/2 inch here is okay. You can do the same at the ankle. 1/2 inch here and 1/2 inch here. Then you connect. Then I also thought that you can just blend it directly. Like if you want to have a pencil trouser, you want it to be slim there. But slim is in a way that you can actually still remove it. What you will do is connect from here. You just like line it up back. So, just, you know, from here now, you would grind it. It's actually tricky, but you can do it. just connect from the ankle, you keep going up until you have met that point. Then another way is you can still add that half inch, the half inch you added here, you can still add it here and add it here as well, okay? All this is for you to balance your trouser. Like I said, you can go direct. That is not adding anything at this side. It depends on what you want. This particular one is a matter of choice. For me, I didn't add in the trouser, like this very trouser you're seeing on the screen. I didn't add this, okay? I just slimmed, fit it from here to this point and connected up, okay? But if you want it a little bit free at this point, you add your half inch here, add your half inch here, and you connect, okay? So for the sake of this tutorial, let me just connect like so. So this will help, like the first one I explained, will help you to avoid unnecessary shaping by the time you're done joining your trouser. This also will just give you free trouser down. That is not free, not a straight cut per se, but you know, fitted free trouser. So that is just the idea. Okay, now let me connect from here to here. So you need to connect from this crotch line to your knee. Okay, so don't over add hip to your trouser by yourself. Just allow the natural hip to come out on its own. Then here, now again, this is where you need to curve your back, okay, at this side, so that the allowance you're adding will not be too much, because actually we need that extra at the back because of the way the back is full. But this is where you really have it. Then though under the crotch too, you need it. But you know, the thigh area also should like lap with the front. That is why we usually cut here. That is why we usually curve the back part at this side. We have gotten the length we want for our crotch to accommodate the butt. But this thigh area shouldn't be too bogus. That is why this pants curve was made, okay? So that you can curve it depending on what you want. So this is how I usually place it. I have different types of pants curve, okay? So this one goes this way. Just meet the nail like so. Okay, you see what we have there? Now from the nail, you go down like so. Okay, and this side you do the same thing. So make sure it is matching. Okay, then for your extension, you come out by half inch for your hem extension. Also come out by half inch and you just connect. Okay, so you have it here and the back is ready, okay, except for that. Now, to create the dart for the back, just measure what you have here, okay? Remember, you'll be sewing the back, the crotch, the cross side, you'll be sewing it together, so you're not including it. So you measure from what you have here to this grid line, okay? That's what you mark here. Before you mark it, also remove the half inch for allowance you're using to join the crotch. Okay, this is a bit tricky. If you don't really remember, you end up adding everything. So you have to move that half inch, then place your measurements and mark it. So now I can move the front. I think I've traced everything. I can move the front. So the length for back gap is 5 inches. If you're not adding that, that's it. If you're not adding band, you should just fold or hem your trouser at the waist. But if you're adding band, you need to take away the length of the band, okay, before you mark your dart. So the length of the dart is actually 5 inches midpoint. This is where you have it. This is where you should have your dart, okay? Now, at that point, just measure 5 inches. You mark your 5 inches. Then at this line where you have your 5 inches, you still need to measure that 3.5. I hope this is clear. Just measure that 3.5, okay? Now, let me take it again. You see the measurement we have here between this point and this point. That is what we are going to mark here. Now you have to move your half inch for joining the crotch. Okay, so it is from that point you measure the 3.5, and this is it. Okay, then at that point now you come down by 5 inches, because that is the length of the dart. When you have your 5 inches, just note it. Then from this point you also measure 3.5, because you should, you know, the dart should go, it should be parallel to this line. Okay, that is how your dart should go. The way the line is, that's how your dart should also go. So now you connect it. Okay, now you connect it like so. By the time you have done this, now you will take half inch on both sides. Remember the dart is 1 inch dart. So take half inch on both sides and you connect it down like this. Okay, so this is your dart. So everything is just okay. This is your back pattern with the back with your dart. So if you're going to have that in the front, like I explained initially, add your dart allowance and you do the same thing. But the dart for the front is 4 inches. Okay, it's 4 inches and not 5. So your dart will be at least a green line. So now I will cut the back. So before cutting the back, before you cut your back, please, it is very necessary that you mark your new points. In fact, I would have done this before even shifting the pattern. Okay, so it is necessary. Very, very, very necessary. That is what will help you to match up your trouser. So make sure you notch the new point and make sure it is exactly at the new point. Your front and back, so there's a mistake here. Your front and back new point should match up. Then you do same at the ankle. Okay? So you do same at the ankle. So before you move the front at all, you can see you have to do that. You have to do that. So it is already okay. This is actually how it should be, you see. So this is it. So you see why I said you should mark it before actually removing. Hope you are seeing what I'm doing here. So I have to place it back the way it was. I have to place it back the way it was. Okay, so this is actually the nail. You can see all these things are very important, because if you don't do it well, when you are joining your trouser, you end up making mistake. So why I knew that it's not balancing is that this side had to, you know, balance. So you see it. So you also notch your or mark your ankle points. Also mark your ankle points. So if it's on your fabric, before you do it, you notch. Okay, so this is the nail line. So now I can move the front and cut the back. Okay, so you can see our back panel and our front panel. So you can see the difference. You can see the difference. The back is longer here. And the reason is because of the boss. Okay, so I don't wear a trouser and it will look as if you're sagging. So this is it. Now, the balancing. For you to know if your trouser is balanced is this. You see at this nail point, connect the back and the front, like so. Connect it as in, this is the side now. Now, I want to assume we are sewing our trouser. By the time you join this side, you know we are sewing the back and the front at the side, right? And you have it like this. By the time you balance like this, you see that your trouser is balanced. But if your trouser has some kind of funny shape, if you try balancing it, it will not align. By the time you balance it like this, you see the allowance you have here. Okay? So I want to separate it to just make it clear to you. I want to separate it and join. And you can see that I didn't add any more allowance at the back. That is a seam allowance. Apart from the natural, the normal allowance you should have at the back. Okay? Which is... the extra inches you should have at the back, because the back is fuller. Apart from that, I didn't add any other seam allowance because we took the seam allowance from the front. Okay, so this is my front pattern. This is the back. Now, sew your trouser. This is just a basic trouser. We're not adding zipper, we're not adding editing this, I mean, you're not adding zipper fly and everything. Now, you sew your crotch. If you're adding zipper, this is where you should add your zipper. With your zipper allowance, you add your zipper, right? Then, let me just join everything. This is paper, just to show you what we are interested in here is to see that our trouser is balanced, okay? So I'll use my pin to just hold everything as if I have stitched it. So I'll do that so you see. So you stitch your front crotch with either your zipper and every whatever you want to do. And if you're not adding zipper, you want to add elastic. The measurement you should take at the waist is your, that is measurement you should place at the waist should be your hip measurement, okay? So I hope that cutting I did initially will not affect this my front panel. So all the same, this is just paper. So if I'm to use the paper, I'll just use this front side that I have my mark on. So you stitch by the half inch seam allowance. You can see what I'm doing. So I assume I have stitched by the half inch seam allowance. If you're adding zipper, your zipper too would. You know, this is where you stitch your zipper. So that is it. So this is it for the front. Okay, and you can see the crotch area. Then I'll do same for the back so that I can match up the back and the front. So I have, okay, pins to crotch for the back. And this is it. This is it for the back. You can see what we have here. And this is it for the front. You can see what we have here for the front, okay? And one more thing, in some trouser pattern, you see that the front, okay, they come down by either half inch or 1 inch at this crotch side and cut it up to this point. Now, I don't do that because by the time you cut out half inch or 1 inch from your crotch depth, it will affect your crotch in the sense that your crotch will become smaller. So that's why I don't do that. So if you must curve it, add to your crotch measurement, that is your crotch depth measurement before marking. So for example, if your crotch is 9 inches, I know you will be cutting out the side, please mark 10 inches so that whatever you cut out here will not affect your crotch depth, okay? And another method too is to extend this side. Instead of cutting on this side, extend this side by half inch and you connect. In that way, you still have that curvy look. So that is just the essence of that curvy on that slant, to have that curvy look. But even without doing that, you still have your trousers are coming out nice. You can see this very pattern I use. That is what you're seeing on the screen. Okay, there's no cutting or slanting. So this method works well as well, even for people that have big tummy. Okay, and by the time you wear your trouser, everything will relax. So this is it. Now I want to match it up on the back so I'll see what we have here and see how you should match up your trousers. So let's take this side to be a good side and this other side to be the wrong side. The way we stitch normally. So the good side matches up to the good side, right? So this is it. So for pocket, zipper fly, and other things, your trouser alteration, you can join our trouser class. So now, see the reason I said you should mark your new point. Now, okay, if this were to be fabric, what would have done is to notch. So let me notch, since I am actually making it look as if I'm using fabric, what I'll do is to notch so I can transfer my new point to both sides. So just notch on this side and you notch on this side, okay? So by the time you have done that, you also do same on your front panel. Front panel, because you can see the mark did not appear on this other side. So you notch here as well and you notch. So the new point is more important, okay? By the time you match up your new point, the other parts should fall in place. So now let's join. Just place this like so, and this like so. Okay? So match up your nail points. Starting from the sides. Match up your nail points. So you match it up here. Okay? So by the time you have matched it up here, you can then stitch from that nail point down. You stitch. Then from this other side, you stitch as well. So I'm not going to just run the pin all through and see the position. Let me just hold it and tap it. So you just can see everything matching up, everything aligning well. So this is what we call trouser balancing. Okay? This is what we call your trouser balancing. So this is it. If you draft correctly, you see everything balancing well. Okay? And if you see your trouser, if you see the back, because it's a we have extra back. So by the time you match it up, this is how it should come. Okay, you always see that at your trouser, seeing that the back is the back has more fabric than the front. So you still match up the new points. So as we are in seam, okay, you still match it up and in seam as well. You match the nail point and you also match the ankle points, okay. So you just try to match it up. So now you then come to the crotch, okay. You match your crotch. So usually when you are sewing, you open up the seam, open up your seam like so. And open up the front seam as well. Open it up. Then you place it together and you sew. Okay? So you actually have to do this gradually. This paper, I don't want it to tear. So if it's your fabric, you see it relaxing. You can see. So just place it. So you can see. Are you seeing this already? Are you seeing this? The sides here, just match, and you see your big point, your big area, you just stay the way it should be. Then at this side, you have it like so. Okay, so you have this side of the back coming over like this, and the side would just stay normally where it should be at the side of your body. Okay, while this side would just the inseam would come in like so, and you have it. So also join this other side as well. And then remember when you're stitching, you stitch by half inch allowance. Okay, you stitch by half inch allowance. So I don't really have much pin left. I don't have more pin left on my table. Okay, but with this, I believe you have understood how to make your trousers. Okay, so please like this video, yes, give it a like to enable me to create more videos for you. By the time you show me you like what I'm doing, it will encourage me to do more. And also support my channel, please, okay, by watching the adverts. That is the only way YouTube can give us some money, by watching the adverts and, sharing with your friends. So you can see the waist, and you can see that the back is higher than the front. This is how it should be because of the butt rise. Okay? You can see everything staying well. If this is to be on fabric and you put it on, you'll see that we won't have issues at the crotch. Okay? You can see the back side as well. So this is actually paper and it's going to be on fabric. By the time you sew by your half inch on this side, sew by your half inch on this side, you'll see the real shape of your trouser, and you see how beautiful it will be. Okay, so I'm just like folding it to show you the real shape. And on this side, you also stitch by half inch, so you just imagine how it will be. Okay, so I hope you like the video. Please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to share it with your friends so that others can learn. Okay. And if you are yet to subscribe, please subscribe. Hit on the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell beside it so that whenever I upload a new video, you'll be notified. And if you want to see the full package of our trouser making, just join the class, okay? There's a number showing on your screen. Send WhatsApp message to get details about the class and join. It's for a token, actually, it's for a token. And you see the full package, the crotch, and every other thing. So, you see how to make your zipper fly, bands, and other things, okay? So, that is it. So, thank you so much for watching and remain blessed. See you in my next video.